Hi, I'm Mark Hess, and I'm the board president for the Lawrence Board of Realtors. And I just wanted to take some time to remind people to get out and vote. Voting will be starting October the 1st and will end on October the 17th at 8 a.m. You'll be getting an email from the board office also on the ballot as well, and we'll ask you to vote on a proposed bylaw change on how we handle our elections. A presidential advisory committee was created this year to look into how we conduct our election at the Lawrence Board of Realtors. The presidential advisory committee met this summer and looked at how NAR's model bylaws for elections were handled, also on the surrounding boards around us, how they do their elect their candidates for their board of directors. So they looked at all this procedure and they have made a proposal that was ratified by the board of directors, and we are now putting it on the ballot for you to vote on. I kind of want to give you a little bit more information as far as how this is going to be, why it is necessary. Why is this necessary? The contested election results in some of the best candidates not being elected. It becomes more challenging each year to nominate 12 candidates. And candidates who are not elected, often it's difficult to get them back. So just what is being proposed? The structure of the nominating committee and how we elect officers for next year will include two members at large, two brokers at large, and also two of the current board of directors, along with the president and the past president. So the process of how we elect will not really change that much. We'll still nominate at least one candidate for each of the open positions. It'll also give the opportunity if folks want to put their name into a ballot by getting a petition. And it will also will establish minimum criteria to serve on the board. Example, if they are on a current committee or what they're volunteering with the board is. Membership will vote on the directors for the board, and then the board of directors will vote on the officers. Implementation of a succession plan, the secretary automatically ascends to the president-elect and then to the president. How will these changes improve the election? Fewer candidates will be required each year to fill out the open positions. Quality candidates will not oppose one another and can then be elected on the board of directors. And overall quality and experience to the board of directors will improve. Candidates from small offices will also likely accept nominations from the slate to be on the slate of candidates. What does not change? Anyone may run for position on the board of directors by completing a petition. No more than four people from the same office may be elected to serve on the board of directors. The nominating committee will continue to nominate the strongest slate of candidates possible. So why we're doing this is just to make our the Lawrence board process easier and hopefully make our process about having our board of directors even strong. We wanted our members to be aware of the proposed changes to the bylaws. If you have any other questions, please contact me or Rob at the board office or any of the board of directors. Thank you.